unglaublich. The fog in Poland is thick. I'm a German tank commander of a Panzerkampfwagen 5 Panther with a 19th Panzer Division. Our situation here outside Warsaw is critical. We must cut off a Russian assault on Army Group Center.
I'm a Russian tank commander of a T-34 with Soviet Third Tank Corps. We are inching through fog that blankets valley between the Danube and Vistula rivers. Our goal now is to drive Germans all the way back to Berlin.
Our crew has not slept, but we have discipline. We mean to spot the enemy first and strike quickly.
The men are enthusiastic, but most are farmers with little experience driving a tank. Some are just boys. But we move as one, relentless, determined. Our Red Army has ripped a hole in the German lines, and we now control the Eastern Front.
The Americans, British, and Russians have us in a vice. We must make our stand here in Poland, or be driven back into the fatherland.
Our artillery, our armor, our infantry are like a great and terrible lance, piercing the heart of the German devils.
Their numbers are greater, but we face them with better equipment. Our Panther is equipped with excellent optics, high-quality periscopes for the driver, hull gunner and loader. This gives us a great advantage in this fog.
Chartreuse, visibility is crap in our T-34, and the fog, it only makes it worse. Our driver's viewport allows him to see no better than a newborn kitten. As commander, I see little through the clouded vision ports on the cupola. I must rely on a binocular periscope. My crewmen have only a single periscope or a narrow vision slit to see out. When our tank's hatches are closed, my crew is essentially deaf and blind.
Our Panther is a formidable fighting machine. Its broad tracks distribute the tank's weight evenly, and our good suspension and powerful engine help it overcome obstacles.
The German Panther is over-engineered. 2/3 of them have mechanical breakdowns that require special repairs. And for every one Panther the German factories produce, our Russian factories produce 5 mechanically reliable T-34s.
Our Panther has 18mm of hull front armor sloped at 35 degrees. That is superior to any T-34.
Our T-34 cannot maneuver like the German Panther. But water, mud, snow, there is no terrain we can't traverse. We must get into position to get side hull shot.
Wait now. Was ist los? Up ahead. Ja, tatsächlich. Russian tanks. Wilhelm, do you see this?
Jawohl, Herr Kommandant. T-34s.
How many?
I count 4, Herr Kommandant.
Sehr gut. They can see us through this fog. Target the closest.
Jawohl, Herr Kommandant.
Main gun. Armor piercing round.
Los. Los.
The fog is lifting at last.
Tavarish, Commander. Tavarish, Lieutenant. German ahead.
Panther, get ahead, driver, turn, loader, prepare.
Steady, we have the beast caged, don't rush the shot.
Crank the turret, crank faster, don't let the Krautwigs fire on us from the front. Don't let him.
Wait for it. Wait. Now, firefly.
Weapon of the Third Reich was never defeated in battle. Speculation has it that in the winter of 1945, while escaping from sheer numbers of Allied forces, it attempted to cross Poland's narrow Czarnia River, broke through thin ice, and became stuck in shallow water. In all probability, its crew then scuttled this Panther so that it would not be taken by the Red Army. Nearly 50 years later, this Panther Ausf A was recovered from the Czarnia River. Through tens of thousands of man-hours, it was restored by craftsmen of the Military Vehicle Technology Foundation in Portola Valley, California, under the watchful eye of renowned collector Jacques Littlefield. Upon Jacques' passing, the Littlefield family moved this tank and many other historically significant military vehicles to the American Heritage Museum. The fully restored Panzer V stands before you today.